Oh my God, this is so funny because believe it or not, I just saw a patient who kind of has that look like an hour ago downstairs. Maharis dan saya Medical Director di Maharis Clinic. Selamat datang di Maharis YouTube channel.
Saya adalah Dr. Leon Christian dan saya di Maharis Clinic sebagai Aesthetic Doctor. Dan hari ini saya akan melakukan reaction terhadap film dan juga tayangan mengenai aesthetic prosedur.
Okay, start. Okay, ooh, I cannot wait to watch this.
Just in this one spot right here, and then from the eyebrows down, dead.
Is that a car alarm? He's laughing.
I wanted to go to your cousin Danny here, but he refused to do any work. He didn't want to put his fingers in the pie.
Ooh. It's getting dangerous. This is not. You gotta slow it down.
Oh my God, this is so funny because, believe it or not, I just saw a patient who kind of has that look like an hour ago downstairs.
Oke, jadi udah ketahuan nih kenapa dia dibilang botox guy. Jadi dia melakukan botox di seluruh muka sampai saking lebaynya, cuman mulutnya aja yang bisa berbicara. Bahkan buat minum pun keselak dia, nggak bisa buat menelan.
This kind of stiff result you can actually get for an overdone facelift. Obviously, it's not botox gitu, karena kan, you know, somebody who's had a lot of, or maybe too much facelift, can actually have that really plastic and loss of emotion on their face.
That's why sebenarnya menurut saya botox itu adalah batasnya. Yang penting kerutan kita lebih halus, tidak terkelihatan, tapi ekspresi tidak boleh terganggu. Misalkan kita mau angkat alis, mesti bisa tetap angkat alis, terutama senyum. Kalau senyum mesti tetap kelihatan lepas, nggak boleh kelihatan kaku atau terganggu gitu. Jadi dengan penempatan dosis yang secukupnya dan titik yang tepat, bagus kok sebenarnya hasil botox.
And actually the patient I saw earlier had that and actually she came for botox. So the thing is, I was trying to tell her on a less invasive procedure on how she can improve her looks, like ultrasound, therapy, and all those things, because obviously this person has had too many surgeries before. And to her, she's like, oh yeah, but that doesn't last long and it's not dramatic enough. Saya lebih suka yang pasti-pasti aja. I think I want to get another surgery here for my jaws. I want to get another surgery for my other parts of the, you know. That's when you start to look like that.
Bagian menelan biasa sih enggak sih, karena kan bagian menelan itu otot bagian dalam. Tapi beberapa ada memang pas saya ikut seminar kemarin melakukan botox di bagian leher yang terlalu banyak dosisnya sampai dia nggak bisa angkat leher gitu. Tapi memang beberapa kalau dosis terlalu banyak di leher ya, ada juga yang memang kesulitan dalam menelan, ada juga seperti itu gitu. Tapi ya kebanyakan sih angkat leher susah, senyumnya kaku, itu yang lebih banyak sebenarnya.
That's an extreme case, obviously that's a botch surgical result. Most people don't have that kind of result, but I have seen something, yeah, maybe not to this extreme, but something like that, who comes into the practice because they just love getting facelifts, they just love getting surgeries, and they think, you know, having no lines, having no expression, they equate it with being youthful somehow, which I think is ridiculous. Tapi it's not an overnight process, you know. People get to think like that through a series of procedures, through a series of events in their lives. Okay, teman-teman, thank you for watching. I hope it's been fun and entertaining and also educational.
Dan jangan lupa untuk like, subscribe, comment dan juga share video ini kepada teman-teman kalian.
So I look forward to seeing you on our next program.
Cut.